Are you looking to drive value from your IoT investments? If so, you've come to the right place. Hi, I'm Dave from SAS. If you're an executive, a business analyst, or a data scientist, analytics for IoT can turn your data into actionable insights. Analytics for IoT helps the executive monitor the health of their entire organization, can help a data analyst focus in on specific root causes of issues, and helps a data scientist build, manage, and deploy analytic models across the organization so that you can predict issues and find them before they even occur. Now, IoT applies to a lot of different industries. The demo I'm going to use today is based on manufacturing quality, but I think you'll be able to see that these same steps and processes can be used in your IoT business. Let's start with the demo. So here in the quality dashboard, an executive can monitor their key metrics. In this case, we're looking at revenue and margin. As I look at my regions around the world, I can see that I've got an issue here in North America. If I click on that, I can see that my profit margin is quite low and my revenue isn't doing very well either. On the right-hand side, my KPIs are showing me that my cost of quality is in the red. I want to take a deeper look at that, so I can just double-click on it and now dive into cost of quality. This is a map of my facilities around the world. I see that Portland is having an issue, and although their yield is good overall, I see there's a problem in my products. In fact, product number 4 isn't doing so well at all. Now, as an executive, I could dive deeper into this dashboard, but I really don't have time for that, so I'll pick up the phone and call my quality analyst in the quality department. So let's pick it up from there. As a quality analyst, I want to be able to come in and analyze my IoT data. So that's where we'll start. When I analyze my IoT data, I'm able to select any combination of data that's being collected from my equipment around the world. But I don't need to know that it came from 27 different systems or has 50,000 different cryptic names on the variables. I see the data prepared and presented in a way that I understand it. So I can select things like, I want the Portland plant for product number 4 and a specific time and date range. And as simple as that, I've selected my data, which I can now launch and take into my explorations. Now, during that launch process, there are a few other things that I could tweak. I could set things like, how do I want to interpolate missing values? Or how do I want to set the periodicity of my data? Maybe some of my pressures are taken every second and temperatures are only taken once a minute. I could equate those periodicities so that I've got more consistent data. But now that I've created this data set, I can see here are all the variables that are in that data set for Portland product number 4. And I can simply grab a couple of these variables, in this case, some pressures or temperatures, drag them into the workspace, and the system automatically shows me that a scatter plot is the best way to represent the data. So I can just grab a couple of these variables, drag them over, and in this case, the system automatically decided a scatter plot was the best way to show the data. Now, if I wanted to change that, I can simply right-click, and I can choose from dozens of different types of analytics, from basic reports like trends and Pareto's to more sophisticated things like neural networks and other types of artificial intelligence. Now, in the interest of time, I'm just going to skip forward and show a report that I've already created. Here we see a more advanced version of what we were just looking at, a correlation matrix. And I can do things like build interactions so I can see how my high and low yield data are performing. But instead of investigating my data as an endpoint, I want to take a look at my actual manufacturing process. And that brings me to a path analysis. Each column in this analysis is a different step in my process. In this example, I've got 5 different mixers, 4 extruders, 4 ovens, etc. So this maps out my whole process, and I can see how my batches of product flow through it. Now, if I filter this down to just my low-yield products, I can quickly see that all my batches of low-yield product are flowing through this same oven, oven 2210. So clearly I can see something's going on with that oven. Now, I don't just want to know what's happened in the past. I want to start predicting what's going to happen in the future. So I'm going to build an analytic model here called a decision tree. And in the decision tree, I gave the model several different variables to look at, and it decided that the oven, in this case, that problem oven 2210, was the best predictor of a bad product. And that's what the teal color here represents. I've got about 16% bad product here. And specifically, when product number 4 flows through that oven. But the new piece of information I've got is that when parameter 34, which could be a temperature or pressure or speed, is below a certain value, almost all of my product is bad. So I can very easily now see a situation where I'm going to produce a bad batch of product. Now that I have that analytic model, I could register it so that it's available to now stream against real-time data. But in this case, since I'm the business analyst, I may not want to take that step. I might want to call my data scientist and see if there's more that could be done. So I'm just going to create a pipeline and now switch over to that data scientist view. So as a data scientist, I want to build analytic models. And when I come into the system, I can see the historical data that we started with, the preparation that was done to get that data ready for analysis, and the decision tree that we just looked at. But I've decided I want to compare that to a couple other analytic techniques, in this case, a logistic regression and a neural network. And if I wanted to add others, I can simply right-click and choose them from the list here, allowing me to pick from many different types of analytics to best predict when I'm going to get a bad batch. The model comparison node here at the bottom shows me the results. It looks at the data, compares those three different analytic models, and then allows you to see, in this case, the champion, the best predictor of bad batches, was that decision tree. So in fact, my decision tree is the best one, and that's the one I'm going to use. Now that that model is built, I can deploy it. And that brings me into the last section of this demo. This is event stream processing. Now, instead of looking at historical data, what's happened already, I want to look at data that's coming off of my machines in Portland right now. And that's what this first node represents. The Portland data, in this case, it's connected via OPC UA, is pulling streaming data from the equipment so that I can monitor it, run it through my decision tree, identify any high probability bad events, and then be notified of what's going on. In this case, I have it set up as an email notification, but it could be a text message. It could even use a API to connect to another system that might change a speed or shut down a piece of equipment and automatically. Now, as a final step, once I've built this, I can run a test, and now I'm streaming data through that analytic model, and now I see the data start to flow in. I can even look at a streaming dashboard that allows me to see those alerts being generated. Here's my decision tree model, and each time there's a spike, that's a message that's being sent to let me know that potentially a bad batch is being produced, and I need to make some adjustments. Thanks for joining me today for this demo. Although I used manufacturing quality data, I hope that you can see how these same processes apply to your IoT data as well. Now, your executives will need to monitor the health of the organization, business analysts need to isolate the issues, and data scientists need to be able to build and model those interactions so that they can predict issues before they occur. If you'd like to learn more about analytics for IoT, check out sas.com/IoT solutions. Thanks.